valence shell repel on the electron clouds it like a negatively charged on the central atom. Then next one is the electron pairs localized by the surface of maximum distance from one another. For example, the central atom we have denoted from many bonds, in like 4 bond and then 5 bond, that is the shape will be different. So the distance will be localized by the spherical surface of the bond atom. Then another one is a multiple bond, it will be created with electron pair with 2 or 3 electron pairs given from the single atom. In then like the central atom,
one is a multiple bond
given from another one
with electron,
so multiple of the
2 or 3 electrons
given, so that is the single super pair of electrons.
A multiple bond
given from another one with
electrons,
so multiple of the
2 or 3 electrons.
PSEPR model, we have given to the remaining electrons for given from the
given from another one is
linear, non-linear and trigonal planar, and
PSEPR
model, and we have given to the remaining electrons and trigonal planar, and then
octahedral.
So in the PSEPR model, we have given to the electron pair repulsion. So electron pair repulsion means lone pair of the electron, and lone pair and bond pair of the electron, and bond pair of the electron. So these repulsion using by the VSEPR model. So let's see, the first structure is BHCl2. So this structure, it will be called linear structure. And then 2 legs and 1 hand will be there. Example for BF3. So in this model is trigonal planar structure. Then next one, CH4 methane structure. It's 3 bonded here, so that is called trigonal planar. And third one is CH4, in like 4 bonded will be here, that is called tetrahedral. And 5 bonds here, trigonal,
so that is called trigonal planar. And third one is CH4, in like 4.
So this is the example of the how many bond pair will be here, then what is the shape of the structure. Then next one is shapes of molecule having lone pair of electrons. For example, AB2E. So AB2E, it like a A and 2B of the atoms. So these structures in straight line structure or bent shape structure. So that is called linear and other than bent shape. So different shapes will be here. These electrons used by lone pair of the atoms. That is the shape of molecule used by the VSEPR model.
So different shapes will be here. These electrons used by lone pair of the atoms.
Then next one, valence bond theory. So what is valence bond theory?
Then next one, valence bond.
Any idea?
So, what is valence bond theory?
What is valence bond theory?
Then next one, valence bond.
Any idea?
So, what is valence bond theory?
What is valence bond theory? Chipeta. Kasama. What is valence bond theory? Okay. So in this valence bond theory, it introduced by Hitler and London 1927. It's furthered by another one author is Pauling. Okay. So these three scientists theory, introducing by the valence bond theory. So, in this valence bond theory, there are localized by formed in the two atoms in like donate by the electron. So, one atom donate by the another one atom. That is called valence bond theory. So, let's see the example. Two electrons with opposite spin of the shared pairing of the electrons. For example, hydrogen and then chlorine atoms. So hydrogen, it will be given to the two atoms of the bond. So H2O. So O is a central atom and then hydrogen. So two form of the hydrogen. This hydrogen atom, it's called bi bond, and then oxygen is a sigma bond. So the one atom, it is transferring to the another one atom of valence electrons. Then another one is overlap region. So another one is overlap region. Hydrogen chloride, HCl acid. So HCl acid.
One is overlap region. So another one is
hydrogen is a central atom, and then hydrogen, next one is
chloride, HCl acid. So HCl chlorine. Acid is
okay, this center so atom is called overlap region. And okay, the center atom is overlap region, and these will be called sigma bond formation and other than bi bond formation. Okay. So, center atom is overlap region, and then another one is sigma bond and bi bond formation. So, two electrons, it will be opposite spin given to the overlap region, forming to the covalent bond formation. So, hydrogen and then chlorine atoms. So center of the atom is overlap region, and then this end to end of the atom is bi or sigma.
So hydrogen and then chlorine atoms. So center of the atom is overlap region, and then this end to end of the atom is bi or sigma. So hydrogen and then chlorine atoms. So center of the atom is overlap region, and then this end to end of the atom is bi or sigma. So hydrogen and then chlorine atoms. So center of the atom is overlap region, and then this end to end of the atom is bi or sigma.
Valence bond theory. So see Na minus Ea and Nb minus Eb. Na is nucleus of one atom and Nb is nucleus of another one atom. E is a electrons of one atom and Eb is a electrons of another one atom.
Na is nucleus of one atom and Nb is nucleus of another one atom. E is a electrons of one atom and
are you clear?
Electrons of another one atom. Na is nucleus of one atom and Nb is nucleus of another one atom.
Then next one is
end to end overlap and by bond it meets side to side overlap of internuclear axis. So sigma bond it means end to end overlap and then by bond it means side to side overlap of internuclear axis, that is called types of bond. In this types of bond we have given two. First type is sigma bond. Sigma bond we have what is SB overlapping and BB overlapping. So SS overlapping it means the two half filled of S orbitals along the internuclear axis. SS overlapping it means two half filled S orbitals along the internuclear axis. And SB overlapping also same as half filled orbitals of one atom and B orbitals also half filled orbitals of another one atoms. Then BB overlapping, these BB overlapping also half filled orbitals of approaching the atoms. For example, so these two of the SS overlapping orbitals. In this SS overlapping orbital, only half filled orbital of internuclear axis. So S and S, this is not filled by the orbitals. So SS overlapping and then SB overlapping. SB overlapping, it means S and then B orbitals. So these orbitals also